Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. I hope everyone is good out there. Today I want to make this video about my preference or my point of view of using the ECC81 or in American designation 1287 tubes, and why do I like to use them in a phase inverter position. Before any further ado, let me give a disclaimer right here. If you are a guy that looks for super high gain tone, this might not be a video for you. But if you are like a guy like me that you likes more of a headroom and nice 3D detailed tone, maybe that's a video for you. So it's been like 6 months since I've been using in the phase inverter position the ECC81, and tell you why. Well, I do not have a super extremely high gain amp. I have a Bogner Alchemist, and a friend of mine suggested me, why didn't you try ECC81 in a phase inverter? And I was like, I'm not sure about that, because I really believed that ECC81, it's such a huge difference in gain that would completely make my amp quiet, or, you know, just like the tone would lose like the basic gain that, you know, that it's around and I need. But putting this into phase inverter make whole lot of difference for my sake, for the better. And I tell you why, because like I said, it tames down the gain a little bit. We're talking about that very aggressive kinds of a gain, and gives you a nice headroom. And while playing loud, it does not give you so much extreme feedback and, you know, all the crazy stuff that's going on when your amp goes loud. And here I'm going to show you my four examples that I have. I don't have as many. These are basically the four types of ECC81 1287 tubes that I have so far that I tried. And I'm going to tell you a little bit about them. And let's start from here. This is RFT ECC81. As I mentioned already this tube in a previous video when I talked about German-made tubes, this is a Eastern Germany-made tube. It's very easy recognizable by its unique plate structure. It has very thin plates and very spiky spacers. Usually has a halo getter, right? And now, how does it sound? This tube is surprisingly sounds very well, because I even have the ECC83 version of RFT, and I prefer so much 81 in a phase inverter. Of course, we're talking about what does this tube do? Well, again, it's an ECC81, so it's a 70% gain factor, not 100%. But this tube has a really nice low mids bass push. So if you're looking for that, this tube is a great phase inverter tube if you need a little headroom with a nice push of low mids and the bass. It sounds absolutely amazing. I would say this tube is also a best buy, because it's one of the most affordable new old stock ECC81s, 1287s, and, you know, it sounds absolutely great. I think it's a great tube. Moving next, here is Einish Yugoslavia ECC81. Now, what I noticed with this tube, this is perhaps the highest gain ECC81 1287 that I have. Now, it's definitely less than a ECC83 12AX7 version, but this is perhaps, you know, if you just want to tame your gain down just a tiny bit, right, this would be probably a great tube for you. It has this, I would say, this very nice edge to it, like in the sound, it sounded like pure rock edge to it, and it's really a great tube overall. And again, it's usually you can find them for a good price, so it's a good buy, I would say. And yeah, the Yugoslavia Einishes are famous for being made on Telefunken toolings. The ECC83 version looks identical plate-wise and everything, so I don't know what's really the difference between ECC81 and 83 in a sake of construction, but sound-wise, it has just a little bit less of a gain, so maybe that is the tube if you just want to tame your gain down just a little bit. All right, coming up next, this is my very first ECC81 that I ever received, and this is, it has no markings on it, but I know for a fact this is Marconi Italiana. This is made in Italy, and by the tube design and the black plate, I assume that this could even be from the 50s or maybe early 60s. Like I said, there's no date code, so I can't say for 100% what really is. But how does it sound? Well, really, really well. This tube has a really nice detail on the top and has this almost like a mallardy kind of a low-end push. So overall, it's a very, very nice tube. But like I said, the detail here on the top end, it's really fascinating good. The mids are really nice and I would say neutral. So yeah, this tube is if you can find one, Marconi, made in Italy, that's a great tube for you. And last but not least, here I have an example of, it says Philips Miniwatt ECC81, but I have an actual date code here. It's pretty faint, but this is made in France by Radiotechnique. I'm sorry. It's hard to pronounce certain names. La Radiotechnique from France. This tube is phenomenal. It has a really nice balanced sound and the detail, it's really over the top. So if you're really, really into the detail of ECC81, this is a great tube. And you can still find them around, you know, I have no idea what the price is at. I got it for a good deal, but, you know, the general idea is that those are really good tubes and they have, like I said, very nice sound. And again, if you want to tame your gain on your amp, just adding one of these to the phase inverter could do a nice trick. At least it does for me. Anyways, I hope you find this video informative. Hope you pick up something out of it. Until next time, hope you have a good one. Subscribe for more and see you soon.